Hi guys, Dorota Palicka, international nail artist and educator here, and today we are gonna have fun with some trending nail art. Have a preview of it in here. I always love when the new trends comes up because you can do it in absolutely different ways, and I hope you really like my way. So let's start.
Pretty hard design to achieve, like, and I have tried a few different versions and I stick with this one because I think that one looks best to create this kind of diamond looking nails. I will just actually show you. So I did try with large crystals and then some transfer foil as well. Like, I do have a transfer foil which is like in a diamond shape. It doesn't look bad actually, but I think the diamond stands out too much, so we'll play with the combination. And then I thought, like, okay, I will just try some kind of 3D on top of the transfer foil. It looks not bad, but again, I think I have choose this one to be the nicer look, and I will show you how to achieve this one. So I've got my tips ready in here, and first of all, like, we do want to encapsulate some crystal as well, but not that large. This one just stands out too much. I'm using the fiber gel and clear, and then I've got some glitter. You could actually use any type of glitter, to be honest, like a see-through glitter, or you could even cut your own. So just grab some transfer foil, or like even just a normal foil which doesn't transfer, and just cut into small pieces to create your look. I'm just having an ready glitter particles, and what I'm doing is straight away, just to save the time, I'm picking them up and I'm placing them on the nail. Okay, completely random, just so I've got some sort of background. Okay, pick up another scoop of those glitter. And I do not cure them. I like to save the time. So the clear gel is a bit thicker consistency than the one I usually use, which is crystal one. So I've got enough time to play with the next steps. So my next step is to grab some crystal. And ideally, I'm gonna go, so like they would be a little, maybe this one wouldn't be too large. I will try one with the big one because I quite like the crystal idea as well. So we'll try on the one finger just in the middle, because when I was checking the diamond shape, it is actually rounded in the middle, and then you've got like a wee star coming out from it and then triangles going around it. So I kind of tried to recreate that look, and then we will go for this one because it's slightly, or maybe rounded. Let me check if I would have a one which is more oval, not as square. I definitely should have it because I've got tons of different crystals. I actually do something like this. Yeah, why not? Yeah, I will go with this one. Okay, put the crystals on the side so they don't disturb me. Yeah, I'm happy with this one, and I'm happy with this one. Again, you can see the things don't move, so straight away I can go and pick up my glitter. And this is like a triangle shape. You could also use the rhombus. I think rhombus will look really nice as well. And there are some parts of the design which I want to be kind of more underneath. So that's the edges. And what I'm doing is like at the edges of the nail, because that's where the things can be really annoying if they stick out too much. I'm just placing those triangle shape pretty randomly, to be honest, but just to cover the entire edge of the nail. And so it doesn't stick out. Like, you don't want your clients to be annoyed with this design. This is another thing when trying those diamond kind of nails trend, or artificial intelligence, like, there is so much stuff of going on like this. I wanted to do something which isn't too thick, because as you guys know, I do not like when the nails are too thick. Now the triangle shapes got one side which is a little bit flatter and one side which is sunk in. I am not bothered which side I'm picking up, they both give slightly different effect. Just as long as you don't go outside the tip and they are nice and flat at the edge. And I would say it is a pretty time-consuming set. But I think it looks awesome. You could also wrap some Aurora Chrome underneath. I did it actually on the pinky and on the thumbnail. Okay, second row of them. And again, I'm placing them kind of random. I was trying to do on the thumbnail rhombus shape out of it. And to be honest, the end results doesn't differ too much and it was so much time consuming. So actually placing them completely random does the job same well, if not even better. I'm going to show you that on the other tip as well, what I did. Okay, now the ones inside, I want them to come out off from the crystal, just like this. So it's kind of looks a little bit like the actual crystal. Doesn't matter if you go over the previous ones, just like a wee star shape, I would say. But again, I'm not overly too fussy. Okay, so I have done my first row and it's already looked pretty nice. Let's cook it. And then do the same in here. I'm gonna just show you the difference. So in this one, the placement was completely random. And here I spent actually the entire time to go like rhombus shape, rhombus shape, rhombus shape, then another row of them in a rhombus shape. And then it just, I find it wasn't really that matter. So by the rhombus shape, I mean, I was going like this and this. Okay, two triangles together to create the rhombus shape. And I did full rows of them. I'm actually curious, maybe you came up with the different ideas, like I know you could also bend the transfer foil into different, with different bends you could achieve this kind of diamond look as well. But I just feel it like it wasn't sparkly enough for me. And I do love my sparkles, so I thought this will be a best solution to create that look. And I choose clear tips as well because they kind of tend to reflect the light. So on the client, I would probably do the set just on the clear nails as well, just to make the things prettier and more sparkly. Sorry guys, my tummy will keep rumbling like we are just before the breakfast. I usually find it actually morning time best for me to do the recording. I'm kind of like excited. Okay, let's see what we can came up with. If you do like, I actually really like it how the light reflects from underneath as well. If you do like this design, hit the share button guys, pretty, pretty please. We're trying to kind of push this channel this month and last month, but we'll be probably going back to the usual Monday, Wednesdays and Saturdays. But I hope you have enjoyed those extra videos. Okay, let's do another one. Okay, and that's already look again pretty nice, like a wee diamond. Let's cook it and move on into the next one. Now I'm just gonna swap. So we have done the gel, like on the client, I would probably use crystal one on top of it, but also top coat would work as well. And what I'm doing now is I'm placing the top coat quite a decent amount, not too much at the edges, mainly in like in the middle, because you don't want to create that bulk. And then pick up another diamonds, the triangles shape, and just place them randomly again. So this ones will be a little bit higher and they will look slightly different than the ones which are underneath. Okay, let's cook it. Same in here, right in the middle. can even go over the crystal, like to try to kind of blend it. And I'm just searching where my glitter is gonna stick. But honestly, the rhombus shape would look absolutely amazing too. Okay, let's cook it. And the next row. So it's quite a lot of layers going on in here. So now I'm doing a thin layer of the top coat over the entire set, like entire nail everywhere. I even top coat the crystal, where normally I wouldn't, but for this design I want to, and then place those glitter going a little bit over the crystal. Okay, shake it. But do not cover it completely. Okay, happy with this one. And then I'm basically now searching more for an empty spaces. But again, don't want to go too close to the cuticle area and the side walls. Okay, I think I'm pretty happy with this one. Let's cook it. And you could also achieve those kind of results by going like either with the acrylic or polygel and cut through it like in a diamond shape, something similar to this quilted nails. So this one doesn't have to be 100% smooth. So when I will be doing the buffing, I will just make sure my side walls are like nice and smooth. But the rest, it is okay to be a little bit texture. Again, I'm placing some of those triangles there, just so they blend this large crystal. Yeah, and actually I like it with the large one too. Let me know, guys, your thoughts. And then searching for the empty spaces. I can actually see them because I've got some blue tack underneath. So when I will be sticking them in on my nails to do the thumbnail picture, I don't want it to be see-through, because it will show my nails underneath. And I think I could wear it on my nails. Definitely, I would wear it because I love all that bling. The more, the better. Yeah, I think I'm pretty happy with this one too. Let's cook it. And of course, we have to top coat it all. Could do maybe one more row, but... yes, definitely. I'm gonna do one more row and then top coat it, just because I can still see quite a lot of see-through places. And if you would place it at just in one row, like without of those layers of the top coat, it wouldn't give you the same results like going in multiple top coats or multiple layers of the gel. Like, I think that's what makes it much prettier. Okay, now I am 100% satisfied with this one. Once I place the one here, yes. And I think transfer foil wasn't as sparkly as you can see it. Like, I mean, it is sparkly, but it isn't as sparkly. So definitely glitter is the way to go for those type of design. top coated. Perfect. Let's top coat this one, cook it this one. And now we just have to buff gently because you don't want to have it at like, you know, sticking out at the free edge. It wouldn't look nice on the nails. So when I would do buff this design on the client, I would file their side walls and try to kind of bring the things nice and neat on the sides. File it. Don't worry even if you overfile some glitter. It is absolutely fine. We've got so much of that that it will still look pretty. And then we can also smooth out the free edge a little bit just so it is not too bulky. Grab the buffer and give it gentle buff. It can even buff where the crystal is because we have put the top coat over it. So you don't have to worry about it. We've got top coat there. We are not gonna remove this crystal or remove the shine from it. Okay, happy with this one. Let's do same in here. So we can see it. This is unacceptable because it will be very catchy for a client. Do it on the sides, bring it higher up. So it's nice. Smooth out a little bit in there. But yeah, it's mainly the sides you want to file. Happy with it? Happy with it. And then grab the buffer and just buff at least 70% of the surface because you want your top coat to stick into it. Okay, so buff this one. Clean it and we can reapply the top coat to show you the final results. I also like how they look from underneath. I will actually, once I finish, I will pull the blue tack from underneath and show you how they look as well. So apply the top coat over the entire design. And because of it, they are not going to be catchy or anything like that, but they've got their texture. Really nice and sparkly. With the cameras, it's always difficult. Like, I'm always worried, does it really show the effect, like how it looks in real life? Because it can be tricky. Making sure the top coat goes everywhere, but also it's not bulky at the edges. Let's cook it and then I can show you also how they look from underneath as well. So you can see it. It's a really nice effect underneath as well. And then on the top. Actually, I'm gonna go like... Oh, they still look prettier in the real life than they do in the camera. But anyway, let me show you the entire set which we have created. So this one can go here. And I can actually slap one on my hand as well to see if we can see it through it. So what I would do normally, I would just pull a tiny bit of the blue tack, place it on my nail. They are so overdue, like, and I was thinking I could actually do with the set full of crystals. And then I would just slide it in. Wow, it looks pretty. On the nail, on the actual hand, it looks prettier, much prettier. Let me just find a good angle. Yeah, it does look a little bit like a diamond. And I hope, guys, you have really enjoyed this tutorial. Let me show you all of them as well. There we are. Different angles. Yes, they do look like a diamonds. I hope you're thinking the same. Sending you huge glittery hugs. And see you in the next video.